Well, today I'll go bear hunting. Not polar bears, not grizzly bears, but these are known as water bears, tardigrades, or moss piglets. And I found them in a sample of moss, and today I'd like to show you how I found them and where I found them. If you are interested in the microscopy part, then I encourage you to jump ahead and skip ahead. And if you want to see how I found them, then you just continue watching right away.
So hi, Microbe Hunter here. I'm hiking a little bit today in the forest. And of course, it's also a good place to look for some samples for microscopy. It's early springtime, it's quite dry, so it's not going to be easy to find anything interesting, but actually I did find something, a little bit of moss.
Well, as I walked through the forest, I was first a little bit concerned that I might not find anything interesting, but then I found this gigantic rock there with the moss growing all over it, and I said, okay, that's going to be a great microscopic specimen. So of course I took along a small sample. I always carry along my microscopy toolbox and little plastic containers, and I said, okay, a small sample of moss will do. I put it into the plastic container and then went back home, strolled back home, and of course at home, and that's really important, you have to kind of reactivate the moss, because any tardigrades that are in the moss, they're not moving anymore. They are in this state where they're encapsulated and where they are basically able to survive very long periods of dryness.
Now, there are a lot of rocks in this area, and I read somewhere that they've been deposited during the last ice age. So when the ice came, they moved along and it pushed along a lot of these rocks. And in this process, they were kind of rounded off a little bit, and now they're here. And those rocks, these are also the places where moss is growing, and this is where I took a small sample.
Well, on my way home, I had to overcome a few obstacles. Some of the trees fell over because of the last storm. I nearly bumped my head on this one over here. But in any case, back at home, I immediately took out a piece of moss and I added a little bit of water, because it takes a little bit of time for the moss to absorb the moisture and for all of the microorganisms and little animals that are in the moss to become active again. And this takes a little bit of time. So you have to be a little bit patient here. So the moss was completely dry, and I added a little bit of tap water and simply let it stand for a few days, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days maybe. And I could see a few things here. First of all, the moss absorbed all of the water, obviously, but it also changed color. It got much greener and much more lusher, of course. And after a few days, I could see that the consistency of the moss was quite different, and it was thriving already. And I said, okay, now this is going to be an ideal place to look for some interesting microbes and animals. And I basically washed out whatever came out of the moss, and you can see that there's some leaf particles in there, moss particles, some sand grains a little bit, and this is what I put under the microscope. So a small drop of it under the microscope slide, cover glass then goes on top. Everything went under the microscope, and I was really, really surprised, because I found a lot of tardigrades, really. I've never seen in a moss sample so many of them before. So I don't know if it was luck, really, but actually, yeah, I was quite successful. This one over here is a rotifer. That's another tardigrade over here in the center. Already in this simple drop of water, I found 3 or 4 or 5 of them. Here's another one. Yeah, it's time lapse, by the way. Yeah, because, yeah, you see, and here is another one. Of course, I had to look a little bit closer. I found 2 of them next to each other, also quite nice. And people keep on asking me, well, how do you actually do it? How do you change the colors around so nicely? And how do you make sure that the quality is so good? For example, this one over here is blue. Well, I'm not always using filters, I have to tell you. A lot of the things I'm doing in post-processing. So in the video editing program, I am able to change the colors around a little bit. And this also makes it a little bit more interesting for you as the viewer to watch. Other people also ask me, well, why don't you put the magnification in the corner? And I can tell you, well, those tardigrades, they don't need a lot of magnification. They're not that small. And if you magnify them with your 10 times or 40 times objective, then you're going to see them perfectly. But what I'd like to do is I'd like to zoom in a little bit also into the video, so the magnification in the corner really doesn't make a lot of sense all the time. It might actually confuse people more than it actually helps them. But I just want to tell you, with a 10 times a microscope objective or 40 times, you're going to see them perfectly, and pretty much all microscopes are able to magnify. Here, this here is a small drop of water, which shows that, there's not only a tardigrade there, but also a few ciliates. And can you also find the nematode worm wiggling around? So all of those organisms must have somehow survived the dryness in the moss. Yeah, and it shows that nature is quite resilient here. Those tardigrades, I want to talk a little bit about them now more in detail. When they were discovered a few hundred years ago, people were not quite sure what are they actually. Of course, they're animals, but are they related to the spiders? Because they have eight legs. As a matter of fact, as scientists found out, they're a phylum all on their own. A phylum is right beneath the animals. A phylum is the next largest category. So they're really not related to other animals very much. They're really their own category. And in that sense, they're quite interesting. And they have been studied extensively as well because of their ability to survive dryness. And as I already mentioned, they like to encapsulate themselves. And then when you add water again, they kind of swell up again and they come back to life. Now, I tried to do that and I was successful in the past and I was able to revive many of those. But in this case, it didn't work. It's kind of strange. And I could imagine that maybe the speed of drying is very important here. Maybe if they dry too quickly, then it can be maybe that they're not able to go into a state that allows them to survive for very long. But that is a hypothesis. Of course, I'm going to keep on studying those. Then maybe I'm able to find the right conditions for them to dry. And I know it is possible because I've done this already in the past, but I simply was somehow not able to repeat the experiment here. Those tardigrades do look a little bit clumsy. Sometimes they fall over a little bit and they have a problem really crawling forward. And that's because the microscope slide is so extremely flat and smooth. But as soon as there are some other particles in there, some leaves and so on, they really like to cling to those and they don't like to let go. Yeah, I think what I'm going to do for today is I'm just going to leave it at that. I hope that I also motivated you to hunt for those little creatures. I do have a few other microscopy related channels. I put the links below. I would like to invite you, of course, also to subscribe to this channel if you like it. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you around next time. Bye bye.